In this video, I'm going to be reviewing Sailor's Ink Studio 123 fountain pen ink. I'll go over the specs, I'll do an ink test, and I'll tell you what I like and don't like about this ink coming up. Blake here with Blake's Broadcast. On this channel, I review fountain pens, paper, and ink, and as always, I put links in the show notes in the description below. And if you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. It really helps out my channel. All right, let's get on with the review. This is Sailor's Ink Studio 123 ink. This is a really cool ink. The price is $18 for 20 milliliters, so that's 90 cents per milliliter. And as far as I know, this is the only format this comes in. This is really expensive ink. I am not a fan of expensive ink. However, this one is cool enough that I think it might be worth it. So I do also like their little bottle. It just has a nice, simple, clean design. So let's take a look at the writing sample I did. And this is on a Papermind Cosmo Air Light hardcover notebook. I really like this paper for ink. It just really shows off ink quite nicely. This ink, it changes colors a lot, and it's very susceptible to the paper that you're using. So it's kind of a purpley gray is how I would describe it in normal circumstances. Now, there is quite nice shading, and you can see kind of like I don't know if you can see it. There's like a blue sort of edge to like the shaded areas, or a bluish like teal color that's really quite nice. Now, there's no sheen, there's no shimmer on this. It's really about shading. And if we compare it to some other papers here, you'll see kind of the difference in color. So this is Mitsubishi Bank paper, and just look at how green it looks on this. It's crazy. Now, Mitsubishi Bank paper is not a good paper for maintaining ink color. You know, out of the papers that I test here, Mitsubishi Bank paper is most likely to change the look of a color. But yeah, here we really get a green color, which is pretty unusual. And then on the Rhodia, it looks a bit more like Cosmo Air Light. And just to do this live so you can see it here, how it looks different. Now it goes down kind of blue, right? But then once it dries, you can see it's already changing color to this like greenish color. Pretty interesting. I don't know why that is, but it's quite a nice looking ink. Because it is so light though, I would say legibility is low. This is definitely not something you want to use in a professional setting. And for me, I enjoy this ink, but if I only had a pen filled with this, it would probably drive me nuts. I don't want to do long form journaling with this particular color of ink. It's just a little hard to read, I think. Now, in terms of dry times, it's quite a fast drying ink, which I do definitely appreciate. 15 seconds on Cosmo Air Light, and it looks like 15 seconds also on Mitsubishi Bank paper. So that is quite good. Lubrication, when it's a light color ink like this, I expect dry flow. We don't actually have that here. I would say it's in the medium to average range. It writes pretty nicely in most of my pens. I enjoy using it. I don't really discriminate about which pens I put it in, because the lubrication, you know, it's there enough that if the pen is set up properly, it's going to write nicely. And yeah, I was surprised for that, because usually lighter colored inks are not that smooth. Now let's do some live writing here. To do that, I'm going to use an ink miser, and I'm going to transfer that just a bit over here, because this is so expensive. I don't want to waste any of this ink. We'll see if that's a big enough fill there to get my pens working here. So, put the cap on here, and going to be using a Kakimori. Oh, come on. Kakimori brass metal nib with a aluminum Kakimori holder here. Really like these for testing inks. Okay, now this is going to be Sailor Ink Studio 123. Yeah, it's just really cool how you kind of get like this blue sort of surrounding outline on the ink. It's really pretty neat. Okay, let's do the cock. This is the Kakimori pen nib. This is just kind of like a regular fountain pen nib, except it's really easy to clean, so it's great for testing inks. Kakimori pen nib. Then we will try the folded nib here. Let's see if we can get enough there. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Ink miser is, I think, a must-have tool if you're an ink person. It just makes testing this so much easier. Although, doesn't make it easier to use this nib, though. Try the ornament nib. Yeah, it's a really fun color, I think. Okay, let's do the water test here. Gonna use this Caran d'Ache water brush, which is pretty fun. Here. Okay, we'll let that dry and I'll come back. It's not very water resistant. I mean, yeah, I would say it's really low water resistance. It's not going to be an archival ink at all. It does look so cool, though. I will say, I just love that teal highlight that you get on this ink. It's really just a fun ink. It is expensive. It's not, I don't think, an everyday kind of ink, but it's a fun one that I enjoy. So, what are my pros and cons for Sailor's Ink Studio 123 fountain pen ink? Well, the biggest pro is I think it's a really unique color. It is a purpley gray, but it kind of has these sort of teal outlines when you put down a lot of ink. It's just a really interesting, unique looking ink. It's a fun ink. It dries quickly. It cleans out of my pens pretty easily. And just overall performance is very nice. Average flow works quite nicely in all the pens that I've put it in. Now, in terms of cons, it's expensive. $18 for 20 milliliters is pretty expensive. That's 90 cents per milliliter. And I believe this is the only format it comes in. So, very expensive ink. It's also not that legible because it's a lighter color. Now you'll be able to read it just fine, but just it's not as easy on the eyes as like a dark black ink, and it's probably not suitable for a professional setting. But other than that, really nice ink, definitely unique color. I'm happy to have this one in my collection.